Hello everyone, welcome back to Game Dev Box. Today let's go on creating a script to rotate our 3D model objects using the mouse. I highly recommend utilizing the input system, which is much better than the old input system in efficiency and functionality. So let's begin by downloading and installing the input system package and ensuring its activation in the project settings. Create an input action and name it whatever you want. Open it and add an action map. We require two actions. The first is for the left click button, which is a type of button. Remember to attach a press only interaction and set the binding to left button mouse. For touch input, add the press single touch. The second action is for mouse delta, so name it mouse look and set the action type to value and control type to vector 2. Add the mouse delta as a binding and primary touch delta for touch screen. Save it and now let's create a C# script. Add the input system to your library and then use the input action assets to catch the action map we have just created. Attach the script to your 3D object. For instance, I will be using a cube for demonstration purposes and put the input action into the script. Next, let's add properties to enable control over our input actions. Also, write the two input action properties, the left click mouse button and mouse look. Next, we need some fields and variables for later use. A boolean rotate allowed is allowed to rotate only when we press the left click button. Store the camera reference and float speed for rotation. And the boolean inverted for inverting the axis of rotation. In the awake function, which we'll call in the first frame of our game, even before the start function, find the input by their names and check if it is not null. Let's say what we want to do when pressed or performed or cancelled. So I added a protected virtual on left click press function to set the rotate allow to true when it's started or performed. And when we release the left click mouse, it will set the rotate allow to false. For reading data of mouse look input, add a vector 2 function named getMouseLookInput. Check if the input action is not null, then read vector 2 value. Otherwise, return vector 2.0. We can put these codes into a function to clean our script. In the start method, if you want to disable the cursor, add this line and then get the camera reference. In the update function, which will call every frame, first check if the rotate allowed is false, return, and avoid calculating any data so we don't hit the performance. Then let's store the mouse delta to a vector 2. Also, we can expose it and use it to catch it in memory and reduce the CPU work. But this is fine for us now. Multiply this mouse delta with the speed and time.delta time. Use transform.rotate to rotate game objects. Set the axis to vector3.up and multiply it by 1 or minus 1 for inverting the axis. And set the angle to mouse delta.x and determine the rotation of the object in world space, not in local. Use the exact code for the right axis with a different angle, which we give it mouse delta.y. That's it, we can just clean the script by regions. So I set the speed to 120 and I want to invert the axis. Work as expected, but I think there is a problem with this inverting. Let me just fix it by changing the code here. Thank you for watching. I hope this tutorial proves helpful. Don't forget to subscribe for more tips and tutorials in future videos. See you next time.